feel we knew him, but we never felt we knew under the skin of Brian. But maybe there was nothing more to see or know, because he told it all in his words.
My name's John Christie. I had a sort of double career, really. I was an artist and a cameraman, and I kept them pretty separate. This programme that I worked on with Brian was called Travelog. It was on Channel 4. The excitement of going to Pakistan, I'd never been there before, was tempered after a few days because Brian was in such a bad mood.
He had a sincerity of himself and he wouldn't deviate from it. You know, some people, you might think that they're an act and their writing is part of the act, but you never felt that with Brian. Most of the time he got along with editors and they revered and feared him a little.
While we were in Pakistan, Brian was taking notes all the time. And he'd be writing when we were going along in the crew bus and obviously writing in the evening. We rescue fallen donkey from ditch. I remember that. That was, I think, in Chitral. And it was some poor animal. Donkey was piled up with bricks on its back. And it was just, its legs had buckled under it. And I remember we stopped. Brian was in. was very furious, and then we unloaded all the bricks off the back of this donkey so it could stand up.
He was very human, and if that's the right term, with animals. He loved his dogs. To animals and wildlife, he was hugely painstakingly considerate, but not necessarily with some other humans.
I suppose, you know, the thing about archives is it's likely they'll reveal what they really feel about something, or their prejudices. So I suppose you would get the secret life and the public life. I began the editing the week after we got home, before I could show Brian the rough cut. He was taken ill and suffered a heart attack. He recovered, but the programme still isn't finished. He has to record the voiceover, and he didn't like that first cut, saying that it wasn't the country he'd visited. It looked too interesting and didn't reflect the level of pollution and cruelty that he'd seen there. I'm still negotiating on these points. Hopefully soon it'll be done. But I still think it was a fantastic trip.